How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And just answering a quick question here, a very common question: can a VPN be hacked? Now, most attacks tend to involve stealing the keys. Spy agencies, for example, generally prefer this method over the complex task of breaking encryption, given that the math behind encryption is computationally complex. Stealing a key is a far easier task. Their success comes from a combination of technical trickery, computing power, cheating, court orders, and behind-the-scenes persuasion. VPNs can be hacked, but it's hard to do so. Furthermore, the chances of being hacked without a VPN are significantly greater than being hacked with one. Because when you're using a VPN, you're not using your real IP address, and you're using the encrypted servers of the VPN. So it's very tough to get hacked while you're using a VPN. Now, you may have heard that the NSA were able to break the 1048-bit encryption, but their success was based on the exploitation of a weakness in a common implementation of the Diffie-Hellman algorithm. The root cause of this weakness stems from the prime number used to implement the encryption. The researchers estimated that it would take about a year and a few hundred million dollars to build a powerful computer that would be able to crack a single 1024-bit Diffie-Hellman prime. This is a cost the NSA can afford, but it wouldn't be enough to decrypt the multiple encryption keys that secure millions of websites and VPNs. Unfortunately, the researchers found that only a few prime numbers are commonly used for 1024-bit encryption. This includes applications as VPNs, and therefore makes it even easier to break. Now, VPNs don't need their encryption to be compromised to make your connection vulnerable. One of the simplest ways your data can be revealed to an outside party is via VPN leaks, which is why I picked these three VPNs, because they have been continuously audited to make sure that they don't leak any DNS or IPv6 leaks. In the process of transmitting your data, your browser may still leak your real IP address. They may not have access to your traffic data in this case, but they can trace your location, which is why it's very important to use a premium VPN with proper 256-bit AES encryption. And with these VPNs, they use 2048-bit as well as 4096-bit keys. Now, remember, it takes a year and a few hundred million dollars to break a 1024 key, let alone the time it would take to break a 2048-bit key or a 4096-bit key. So it's a very difficult job. So technically or theoretically, it is possible to hack a VPN, but it's an incredibly complex and costly task that even the NSA would have trouble breaking these codes. So while it may be possible to hack a VPN, it is a very unlikely event to take place because it's simply too costly. There are other ways to compromise a VPN server besides decrypting the keys. Again, as I mentioned earlier, such as making use of the DNS and IP leaks. But thankfully, these three VPNs, after having tested a couple dozen VPNs, these VPNs have been proven through the audits and whatnot that they do not leak anything and they have strict no logs policy. But to sum up these VPNs, I don't want to make this video too long. If you're looking for the best VPN overall, go with ExpressVPN, especially if you're very privacy and anonymity conscious. If you're looking for something that's a little bit cheaper that offers you more features and focuses more on performance, go with NordVPN. If you're looking for the best budget VPN that gets the job done at the cheapest possible cost, go with Surfshark. So if you guys are interested in any of these VPNs, or if you'd like to learn more about them in terms of the privacy policy, speed streaming, torrenting capabilities, as well as security features, be sure to check the reviews down below. You'll also find links to pricing and discounts. Besides that, keep in mind that they do have 30-day money-back guarantees on all their plans, so you can try out these VPNs for 30 days at least, risk-free. And if you're not satisfied, in the unlikely event that you're not satisfied with any of these services, you can just contact their 24/7 live chat support and ask for your refund. Besides that, comment below if you have any questions. I'll be happy to answer all of them. Like and subscribe if you'd like to support the channel and stay up to date with everything VPNs and cybersecurity. Thank you guys very much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Have a wonderful day.